Hey everyone, I'm King. Welcome back to King's Pet channel. So currently I'm playing a Taiwan server as Hunter. This is my progress at the moment. So I'll be showing you my Hunter build. In this game, there are three recommended playstyle or build for Hunter. The first one is the range attack type, or I like to refer it as the shooter. The second build is the trapper. And the last one is using Falcon to attack, or I like to call it the Falcon user. I am playing my Hunter as the shooter type, so I'll be showing my build more on this type of gameplay. First, I will talk about the state point distribution, second the skill set, and lastly the equipment that I'm using. Alright, let's dive in. First is the stat points distribution. In this game, we will be adding all stat points to the dex. Why you would ask? It's because dex is Hunter main stat for physical attack. By adding point to dex, it will increase our range physical attack, also increase our haste, which can shorten our skill variable cooldown so that we can cast skill more often. I think this is more of a bonus to shooter type hunter, because most of the time, shooter type hunter will rely more on fast attack speed and crit, not so much on throwing skill. And the last one, it can increase our hit, so we do not miss when attacking. Now you will wonder, how about AG and luck? You might be surprised to hear this, but we do not have to put any point on AG and luck at all. These two stats can be easily compensated with the equipment and cards. I will talk about this later. Now, adding point to a state will have a limit. Currently, the maximum limit point for any state is 80 points. So when we reach that number, I suggest to add on Vit so we can have more survivability when farming at higher level monster or MVP hunt. From playing in Taiwan server, the information that I got is, when adding point on AG, it will increase about 0.5% attack speed or ASPD. And adding point on luck will add about 0.08% crit. Adding it higher will slowly decrease the percentage amount. So I don't see that it is beneficial in the long run. Anyway, that is for you to test according to your playstyle later. Okay, next is the skill set. When you are still an archer, haven't changed job to hunter yet, your main damaging skill will be the double strafe skill. Put it to level 5 to unlock the arrow shower skill. For now, just put the shower arrow skill to level 1. Next, the arrow repel skill. This skill is mainly for PvP because of the stun effect. Usually, if you are not doing PvP, you will not want to put point on this skill, but for the time being, just put it to level 1 so that at least we can use it. Next, the Owl's Eyes and Vulture's Eyes skill. These two are passive skill. Whenever you see skills with square icon, it means that the skill is passive skill, and circle icon skill is an active skill. So Owl's Eye skill will increase your dex, the Vulture's Eye skill will increase your range of attack. So we definitely need to max these two skill. Next is the Elemental Arrow. At max level, this skill will increase your other skill damage by 10%. Using other elemental arrow like fire arrow or water arrow will add ignite and slow debuff. So we also want to max this skill. This is all we need for archer skill set. The remaining skill point will be used when we change to first job class hunter. Alright, for hunter skill set, let's look at the skill improve concentration. At max level, it will increase your AG and dex by 20 points. If you feel like, well, 20 points is not a lot, then you can consider to up the skill, disband, or focus shot instead. This band at max level will increase your damage to brute, insect and fish monster by 10%. Focus a shot, on the other hand, is Hunterman damaging skill. So either way, you want to max all these three skills. Focused shot at max level will have a 550% attack plus 1300 damaging attack, which is a lot. However, it will have a long cooldown too. 30 seconds variable cooldown plus 5 seconds fixed cooldown, that is a total of 35 seconds cooldown. This will feel to some not that efficient when farming. Well, you can adjust the skill level at the skill tab to any level that you feel efficient for you. This is one of the nice features that ROX have. Alright, from here onwards, it is really will be looking at your playstyle and preference. Some may want to see the falcon fly and do damage. If so, then you can up the skill level for falcon mastery and steel crawl. Or if you feel that as a shooter build, you will not be benefit from using the falcon, because unless you up your INT, the falcon will not be attacking as much. Then you can put your remaining skill point to double strafe and arrow shower. Alright, next is equipment. I'm using all white equipment at the moment. Now, earlier on I said the ASPD and crit will be compensated from the gear. Okay, first of all, let's look at the accessories and talisman. Level 25 accessories that you get from the Golden Thief Bug instance have a really good stat for ASPD. Strengthening and refining it will increase the final attack speed. Strengthening and refining the weapon also will increase the final attack speed. So we can get most of our attack speed by strengthening and refining the gear. Currently, my attack speed is at 223%. When I have enough attack speed, like 300% attack speed or 500%, I will change the accessory to have crit state, the level 40 accessory from the second instance. Let me show you real quick. This one. Why? Because at the early stage, I am more focused on having attack speed and not so much on crit. Information that I got from Taiwan server, the attack speed can go over 500% to 600 and 700 and so on. From my current 200% attack speed, if increased to 500% attack speed, you can see a significant changes on the attack speed when you're doing attacking. From 500% onwards, the changes in attack speed is hardly make any difference. So only from there onwards, I will change my equipment to have crit state. That is the plan. The talisman that have crit state is the level 70 talisman. So I will be eyeing on that when I progress further in the game. Now for weapon. I had changed my weapon to level 40 white weapon simply because I want to have the set effect. The level 40 set effect will increase your damage by 10% if the target health is below 30%. For me, this set effect is more appealing than the other level white equipment set effect. By all means, you actually do not have to change weapon once you get the 25 level white weapon. Why? Because the best stat of the weapon is the same with the higher level weapon. Here, let me show you. A level 25 white weapon with level 5 upgrades will have the same base stat to level 80 white weapon. So you can actually use the weapon up to level 80. The difference is with the stat effect. So the selection of the weapon is up to you, which stat effect you prefer. The armor, muffler and shoes will be the same. Now for the enchantment, I suggest to put dex for all of the enchantment. The more dex we have, the more attack we will get. We will also get haste and heat. If you have a lot of dex and attack already, then you can change to state with percentage, like attack percentage or speed percentage. Because at the early stage, if you only have a little bit of state, the added percentage value will only give you a little bit of increase. It will make a little to no difference at all. As for the card, I will slot in card that will increase speed and change to crit card when I have enough speed later. For the meantime, I will just make use of what I have at the moment. Well, that's it for my current Hunter Shooter build. With this average build, I can solo clear the Golden Thief bug instance in hard mode with no problem. If this video helps you, please give it a thumbs up, hit the subscribe button and turn on the bell notification. Stay updated, more videos will be uploaded soon. Thanks for watching guys, and as always, happy playing! Bye bye!